So you live in the Caribbean and you want to invest in foreign stocks because big stocks equals big money, right? Well, what if I tell you that you can? What if I tell you that you can have shares in major US companies like Amazon and Netflix without even being a citizen of that country? In this episode, I'll tell you where to start, what you need, and how much money you should begin with. I'm Kalilah Reynolds, and it's time for another episode of Money Mondays, JA, brought to you by Proven Wealth and Bulwark Insurance Agency. Now, before we get started, don't forget to like this video, subscribe to this channel, and click the bell icon so you can be notified whenever there's a new video. Also, subscribe to my newsletter at kalilahreynolds.com where you can read a full transcript of this episode. So, you don't have to be a US citizen to buy stocks in US companies. Plenty of Caribbean citizens are already participating in the US stock market. So why have you been missing all these great opportunities to diversify and build your investment portfolio? Should you change that now? No worries. I'm here to help you answer just those questions. Now first, like in any other stock market, you need a broker. You can choose an international broker or a local one that allows for foreign investors. If you prefer to go international, you can complete the process online by looking for a discount broker that accepts international investors. Interactive Brokers, for example, which was founded in 1978, is one of the biggest US-based discount brokers. It's regulated by several financial authorities globally, and it even has a $0 amount for the minimum deposit. That's right. You can open that account with no money. Other accessible brokers include TradeStation and First Trade Securities. Now, I know a lot of you may be familiar with Robinhood, especially with all the publicity in January over the GameStop situation. Robinhood is a commission-free trading app, which has become very popular in the US. Unfortunately, however, the app-based broker is only available to US citizens or permanent residents with a legal address in the 50 US states or Puerto Rico. So, womp womp on that one. But I do have other options, so keep watching. Now, of course, these US brokers are required to first comprehensively screen any foreign persons using their services. Truthfully, as a non-national, there are a few hoops that you may have to jump through before investing in US stocks because foreign owners and holders of US-based assets are subject to laws intended to protect US interests, naturally. So you'll have to provide adequate identification with a government-issued ID and/or a Social Security card, and also fill out a W-8 BEN form and submit these to the online broker. So what's that W-8 BEN form? Well, it's from the Internal Revenue Service, the IRS, that's the tax man. It's a form that foreign individuals and businesses must file to verify their country of residence for tax purposes and certify that they qualify for a lower rate of tax withholding. In addition to this, you'll also need to submit proof of employment and source of funds, just like here. So once your application is approved, an international stockbroker can help you to manage your investments and ensure that they comply with all laws. Plus, a broker in the US will be familiar with how to navigate the intricacies of the American stock market. But let's face it, doing things online or remotely may not always be ideal, especially with the expensive international calls or the lack of direct communication. Some of us prefer to call locally, visit offices locally, and inquire about services in person. Is there a way for you to do this without signing up with an international broker? As a matter of fact, there is. You can invest in foreign accounts through investment brokers in your country. In Jamaica, Proven Wealth, Sagicor Investments, Ideal Portfolio Services, and VM Wealth are among those that provide access to a diverse listing of both Jamaican and US securities. In fact, analysts from Proven Wealth and Ideal often join me on Taking Stock to talk about the US stock market. Proven Wealth offers an easy, efficient, and low-cost way to invest in the overseas stock market. Their online platform allows internet-savvy investors the opportunity to trade actively in the overseas market in real time. Clients can even access timely updates and equity research with everything at the touch of a button. If you want to open a proven global trading account, you'll need a minimum of $2,000 to start. You must sign a proven global trading agreement, log in online to their platform, and complete a tax form. You enter your security questions and answers, reset your password, and complete two-factor authentication. Now, after the account is activated, you can fund your proven global trading account through Proven Wealth Limited. You'll then be able to trade directly on the PGT platform or mobile app. So investing in foreign stocks can allow you to diversify your portfolio and give you exposure to the growth of other economies. These companies can help you to navigate through investing in new markets and make your money work for you. Research the different opportunities for foreign investment available to you so that you can access larger opportunities for your money to grow. That's it for this episode of Money Mondays, JA, brought to you by Proven Wealth and Bulwark Insurance Agency. Follow Proven on social media at We Are Proven and visit their website, provenwealth.com. Check out Bulwark at Official Bulwark JA on Instagram and online at bulwarkja.com. And of course, follow me on Twitter and Instagram at Kalilah Ray and on Facebook at Kalilah Reynolds Media. Now here's what's coming up on Taking Stock.
JMMB Group Limited is seeking to raise 6 billion Jamaican dollars. That's about 40 million US. They're issuing 2 billion new preference shares for $3 each, with dividends paid every month. We'll explain what are preference shares and whether this investment might be right for you. And later, the analysts weigh in on the latest market developments. The competition is heating up in the gaming industry, with Eazzy giving Supreme Ventures a run for their money. And on the international markets, Pepsi's fourth quarter earnings are looking good, even in a global pandemic.
Don't forget to like this video, subscribe to my YouTube channel, and sign up for my newsletter at KalilahReynolds.com, where you can read a full transcript of this episode. You can click the link in the description box below. I'm Kalilah Reynolds. Let's get this money.